Greetings, malign spirits of Nagash. In today's video, we're going to look at painting rusted metals. Now, to start with, we'll be using lead belt as a base coat. Then we'll use Agrax Earthshade just to shade all over, just to knock the shine off that lead belcher. Once that's all dry, we'll then stipple on a little bit of riser rust just to give that cool rusty effect. And then to finish off, we'll use some typhus corrosion in those deep recesses to give it a nice grimy look. So starting with that lead belcher, I'm just going to use my medium layer brush. Apply a little bit to my palette like so. I'm also going to add a bit more water as well, like I normally would just use a little bit, but for this I might add in a little bit more, because then when I start applying it to the chain links like so, it will flow in a little bit better. You want to do this all over the metals. Once the lead belt is dry, we're now going to shade all over with Agrax Earthshade. This will really help knock the shine off that metallic look, make it look really grimy and ancient. I'm going to do this on all the metallics. And make sure you give it plenty of time to dry. Once the Agrax Earthshade is thoroughly dry, we're going to start stippling on riser rust. Now you want to build this up slowly, so don't rush and put too much on. What you'll see is you'll start to get a nice orangey kind of effect on those metallics. Especially when you start doing it on flat areas like the blade, you can really start to see it's got a real kind of texture to it as well. So it really, really looks like rust. Now you do this over all the metallic areas, but you still want to show some of those silvers showing through, so don't go too mad. With the riser rust done, we're now going to start applying typhus corrosion. Now I'm just going to start stippling this, or trying to keep it into the recesses of the chain links. I'm just going to wipe my finger there so you can still see some of the orange showing through. On the weights at the bottom, I'm just going to stab that a little bit as well. And again, just wiping my finger. And we'll do the same thing on the blade as well. Just keep it in a few little key areas, don't go mad. This will give it a really nice grimy feel. And there we are, with the typhus corrosion applied, the rusted metals are done. I hope you found this useful, and I hope you also enjoy painting your own rusted metals on your Nighthaunt models. We'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.